When you look back at the machines and tractors that farmers used 100 years ago, in comparison to what they use today, it's a bit like comparing a steam engine to a spaceship. And today we're looking at just how far we've come. And I've enlisted the help of a man who knows a lot more about tractors and machines than I do, our farm manager, Martin.
Right, well, let's see how the past stacks up to the present, shall we?
So this is the Fordson tractor, introduced around 1917 for the farmer who was moving from horses to tractors. And it's a real tough workhorse itself, with metal lugs on the tractor wheels and a tin seat there to sit on. Not very comfortable, Martin.
Well, I was just thinking that. So yeah, with these bouncing down the old track and the best tin seat to sit on as well, comforts are going to change a bit, aren't they?
So one reverse gear, two forward. It's four cylinder, 4.1 litre. How powerful would it be?
20 horsepower.
20 horsepower, look at that.
Yeah.
And your big John Deere now is?
410.
Goodness me. But it's got charm, hasn't it? It's got that lovely sort of aroma and look of beauty and old age.
It has, it's got charm, and it's got a fence around it as well. So it's here on display.
Well, that's it. Keep people safe, but they can look back in time and know what our tractors used to be like. These tractors now are just remarkable, Martin, aren't they?
They're amazing from where we've come from. Yeah, definite changes.
In our short lifetime, things have changed an enormous amount.
Yeah, certainly have.
So what have we got here?
So this is our John Deere 8410RX. It does a whole array of different jobs, whatever we want to do. At the minute, it's got the rollers on the drawbar. It's got tracks on to the tyres, so they've got 30-inch tracks on the back here. And then a lot of rollers here to try and keep all the weight down so you get a really good soil contact. And gets the power to the ground a lot better as well, particularly with having the front ones on as well.
And spreads the weight?
Yeah, so you'll spread the weight all the way across this, the same on the front one as well. And the fact that it actually turns now, so it's turning with the front tracks, scuffs the back ones a little bit, whereas the old ones used to be one track, like a big rubber band on one side, which used to really scuff.
Yeah, sure. And what sort of weight is a tractor like this?
It's about 28 tonne.
Goodness me.
I still wouldn't long need to run over me over me toe.
No, exactly. And on the back, you've got all these spool valves for all the different bits of equipment you can put on it.
Yeah, so on the back of this one, there's five double-acting spool valves, which then run anything that we've got on the back. And then on the other side, various different lights, reflow returns, and then quite an important plug here, this little isobus plug. So any implements that are isobus ready get plugged in there, and then they pop up on the screen in the cab.
Isobus meaning that all the technology from the machine you're towing can talk to the computer in the cab.
Yeah, exactly. And I can give that computer messages to then relay back to the drill to change the seed rate in a specific area in the field.
That's incredible, isn't it? Amazing. Yeah. In the past, you'd have to do that with a windy handle, or it would just been a set seed rate.
It just wasn't possible in the past.
Yeah, incredible. And all these ball valves, they're called, is all run on oil. And there's a huge tank of oil in the tractor that then will force that into the machine to do whatever it needs to do.
Yeah, so in the back end of this tractor, there's probably about 230 litres of oil. And then that's used up to go in, obviously not all of it, but used up to go into the hydraulic rams, or it's circulating as well. So that's the idea of the free flow return. There's a lot of oil goes into the machine, through the machine, back into the tractor.
Yeah.
And then it goes to its oil cooler as well.
What about fuel capacity?
Well, best part of 1,000 litres, really.
All red diesel, of course.
All red diesel.
And it just goes in the top?
That's it. So yeah, just literally undo that and straight in there. And then add blue in this one here.
Okay, very easy.
Yeah.
And running an engine that's 410 horsepower.
So yeah, I mean, when it's working hard, 60 to 70 litres an hour.
Yeah.
So 14 hours to a tank.
Goodness me.
And that's why we're hoping that red diesel prices come down.
Indeed. Can we take a look at the engine?
Yeah, let's have a look in.
That's a big bonnet.
It's huge.
So what are we looking at there, Martin?
So all the cooling packs. So for the radiator, for the oils and all the pipes going back, that's a lot to cool down, is that?
Sure, yeah. And then all the driving mechanism is in the guts of the machine here.
Yeah, so the gearbox and the transmission is below the cab. And then we've got the engine here as well, front axle, and then a frame that goes through as well. It's all very skilled now. I mean, everything on there has got sensors, and then it just reports codes in the cab. They're transmitted to the dealership. Very often they know what's wrong with it before they even get here.
Like a very modern car.
Yeah.
And as far as the value of a machine like this?
You wouldn't want to be buying a new one. It'd start with a four.
Would it? 400,000. Incredible, isn't it? Well, a lot of nice cars for that.
Well, it is when wheat's only £180 a tonne as well.
Yeah, it makes it difficult. But I suppose you can have as many cars as you like, but they're not going to plough a field.
No, you've got to have something to go home in, haven't you?
And as the manager, when you've got your team out driving these things, you can see where they are and what's going on from your desktop. Good.
Yeah, so I can either see on the app on my phone where they are, where they've got up to, or we can see it on the computer screen in the office as well. So that's really great to know exactly where they are, what's been done in the day. And it also goes back to like a real time. So if we have a problem with anything, we can go back and say we was in that field at that point there.
Sure.
And especially nowadays as well, proving for our records, for our environmental schemes and stuff like that.
And all GPS and satellite guidance?
Yeah, so all of our tractors and the sprayer is all full RTK system. They're all interlinked, so they all share the same data with each other.
RTK meaning?
Real-time kinetic.
Very good.
I think.
Yeah, so they're all interconnected and you're just using the same lines down the field and driving in a dead straight line.
Yeah, so we've invested in another round of like sophistication really when we bought the sprayer. So that's now all got John Deere kit in it, all got Generation 5. We should all be sharing the same tram lines. And now we're actually using them to steer around the field and put the first tram line in as well. That also keeps us away from the environmental strips.
Incredible, isn't it? So the tram lines being the lines in the field that people, as they're driving down the road, they can see the lines where the tractors do the work, and those are the tram lines that stay in the same place the whole time.
Yeah, that's it, yep.
And as far as your life has gone, you know, moving along from, you know, an open cabbed tractor, you know, using your eye to steer down the field,
I don't think I'm quite that old, Adam.
Oh, maybe you're just a bit younger than me. Or you had much smarter tractors where you were living.
Well, we used to grow veg, so it was worth a bit more.
You had all the money, didn't you? Yeah, I mean, these things are just out of this world. You've got to be a techno wizard, haven't you?
They're absolutely great. Really comfortable cab to sit in. The vision is spot on. But you're in there for a long time during the day as well.
Yeah, indeed. And there's a little buddy seat so someone can sit in there with you.
Yeah.
A fridge to put your sandwiches in.
Yeah, everything. All the life comforts.
Incredible, isn't it?
Yeah.
And because it's self-steering, you can set your line. You don't have to touch the steering wheel, do you? So you can sit there reading my new book.
Well, I could do, yeah.
Although you might fall asleep. Okay, let's take a look inside the cab.
So this is the cab of the tractor. And we've got neutral, forward, reverse and park on this lever here. Steering wheel. And then over here, the main controls for the tractor: engine speed, preset speeds, air pressure, engine oil pressure, fuel, AdBlue. Also got symbols if the tractor's in four-wheel drive or not. And then down here we've got two other screens, so that's a slave screen to this one here, so we can just move from one to the other. And then this is on this screen here, you've got all your spool valves. We've got little hotkeys across the bottom here, so shortcuts to what you want to go and change. I've got gears here, a joystick here which you can link to some of your hydraulic spool valves on here as well, iTech controls, and then up here two cameras. They're generally linked to a camera in the hopper when we're drilling, so we can see what we've got left. And then here, music radio, either linked to your phone or just playing as it is. And then on this radio here, if you get really bored, you can have a chat to your friends in the other tractor or tell him something important that's going on.
Look at this gorgeous machine, Martin. Imagine this going up and down the field, sitting there, wind blowing in your face. You can smell it, feel it, hear it.
I'll take your word for it, Adam. I'll stick to what I've got and I'll let you start in the morning. How's that?
Oh, yeah, maybe you've got a point. But, you know, you can fix this one with just a simple spanner.
Well, yeah. Yeah, all I need is a laptop and a phone.
And I can get the work done. You know, I can, I don't know, what I'd be able to plough. A couple of acres in a day.
You know, you used to be able to plough an acre with a good horse. Three or four with a little tractor like that. And then if you're not doing 5 or 6 or 7 acres an hour with something like this, then that's how times have changed, isn't it?
Two very different eras, two very different tractors, but both built for the same thing, to get the job done. If you've got any of your own stories about old Fordson tractors or any interests in the machines you've seen today, then do leave them in the comments.
Well, that's the end of the first series of Meet the Machinery. If you've got anything else that you want to hear about different machines, then please leave them in the comments too.